So, okay. Today I talked a few words about the influence of protein precipitation methods on uncontrolled conversion of cannabidiol to delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol during analysis of plasma samples. Cannabidiol is the second after delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol most abundant cannabinoid among the nearly 120 identified ones in marijuana. In particular, its biological activates are a topic of many interesting reports that suggest probable therapeutic benefits of CBD. It's being exposed as potential treatment for example, epilepsy, diabetes, addicted behavior, schizophrenia, and many other diseases. The growing popularity of supplements containing CBD stimulates the development of procedures of its analysis in human plasma. Preliminary removal of protein by its precipitation from plasma is still one of the willingly applied plasma sample preparation methods. In general, compounds and mixture, which can be used as protein precipitation agents, can be divided into two groups, neutral and acidic. CBD in artificial gastric juice, which is strongly acidic medium, converts to delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol. In this context, the question arises whether the mentioned compound can also be formed during the protein precipitation process for CBD analysis in plasma by GC or HPLC. To prepare the sample for analysis, an appropriate volume of the precipitation agent was added to 500 microliters of plasma, each containing CBD. Both acidic and neutral precipitation agents were used during the analysis. Their list will be presented in the table below. The samples were vortexed, mixed, incubated for a given time, and centrifuged. The separate supernatants were subject to analysis. The analysis were carried out using gas and liquid chromatography with the use of devices whose specifications are presented in the section entitled Measurements on poster. In the meantime, let's move on the most essential, that is the results. To answer the question if the THC is formed when protein precipitation process is applied as sample preparation procedure in plasma, the supernatant centrifuged from human plasma samples spiked with CBD after their preliminary protein precipitation were examined by 3-fluoroacetic acid or acetonitrile. The results of their GCMS and LCMS analysis are shown in figure 1. As results from the chromatograms, the presence of delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol and all CBD derivatives is confirmed only in the case of the supernatant obtained from plasma sample after its preliminary deprotonization by the acidic precipitation agent TFA, and only by GCMS equipment. That's on this page. The LCMS chromatogram of the same supernatant after protein precipitation by TFI showed the presence of only two CBD derivatives, delta-9 THC and delta-8 THC, formed in trace amounts on figure 1b. The analysis of the GCMS and LCMS chromatograms corresponding to the supernatant after protein precipitation by TFA and difference in the chromatographic separation condition indicates the most of the CBD derivatives are formed in the GC injector. The conditions prevailing in the GC injector, like for example high temperature and slightly increased pressure, favor to accelerate the transformation of CBD to its derivatives. The CBD transformation in the hot GC injector does not occur when the non-acidic precipitation agent, like acetonitrile, is applied for plasma deprotonization. And we see it in figure 1c. Of course, the use of acetonitrile in LCMS analysis also does not generate derivatives, figure 1d. Table 1 lists the protein precipitation agent used in the experiments to check which of them catalyzed the transformation of CBD to delta 9-THC. These experiments were performed with human plasma samples containing 50 nanograms per milliliter CBD. As a result, from the table, delta 9-THC peaks appears only on GCMS chromatograms when an acidic agent was applied for protein precipitation. As a result from the presented data, the application of acidic agents for protein precipitation from plasma samples containing CBD causes the transformation of the compound to delta 9-THC. Also, at room temperature, the transformation process occurs very slowly. Its speed increases significantly at elevated temperatures. The presented results are important not only for the accuracy of clinical trials examining CBD pharmacokinetics and dose therapy effect relationship of CBD and in different diseases. The growing popularity of CBD-containing supplements, mainly CBD oils, in self-treatment of humans can lead to the increased false accusation of innocent people of using marijuana or its preparation when the GCMS system is applied in forensic laboratories. The presented information is only a fragment of the entirety of research described in the article, conversion of cannabidiol to delta 9 tetrahydrocannabidiol during protein precipitation prior to plasma samples analysis by chromatography, troubles with reliable CBD quantitation when acidic precipitation agents are applied in Talanta Journal. Thank you for your attention.